Still a bit warm here in Florida, but really, all things considered, a wonderful fall afternoon for football here in Tampa at Raymond James Stadium. Today, we've got a Week 6 matchup for you here, as it'll be the Detroit Lions taking on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Set to go now in Week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
Hey, kill, kill! Maverick, Maverick!
And Goff going to look to throw right away. He'll find his rookie tight end, Sam Laporta. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. 13 yards on the game's opening play.
Hey, Shell! Shell! What?
Now Goff on first down. He's going to look deep for Watkins. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Detroit! Quez Watkins, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Lions are on the board first here on the road in Tampa. Extra point right down the middle, and it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. Now Mayfield and the Bucs come up on first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Now a third-round pick a year ago. Here's Rashad White. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Now, this defense for the Lions, they were very strong last week in the win over Carolina.
And the big difference in the ball game, their ability to force turnovers, three of them, in fact. Being able to take the ball away, give it back to their offense, that's something that's emphasized each and every week, and they carried it out.
On second down, they'll run with White. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. That's good for a Buccaneer first, a pickup of 12 yards. Now, look, that wasn't a huge gain, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched him more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake. And he's taking care of that early.
And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down. The Bucs at a disappointing 0-4 through the first month of the year. And they come in with fresh legs. They got the extra time off thanks to an early season open week.
And usually your hope is that your open week comes a little bit later in the year. But when you get a chance, get your fresh legs back, you have to take that time and run with it. And that's what they're trying to get done here.
They'll wind up losing three here on the play. And it'll be a third and about 13.
Oh, partner, when you see a screen pass and the defensive tackle ends up making the play, you know that one wasn't sold well at all, because he should be upfield by the time you throw the pass. If not, you end up with big trouble, as we just saw right there.
They're looking for Godwin, but it's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick, and the Lions are going to have it here. At their own 24-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. We have to be thrilled with that first drive that got him the touchdown. Now they'll be looking to make it a two-score advantage here on the road.
And you know, they spent all week in practice, in meetings, talking about taking an early advantage. Being the road team, going up a score, that takes the crowd out of the game and puts some doubt in the minds of their opponents.
Now a second and 10.
79 Broncos.
Here's Willis. The ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. He was looking that time for Jameson Williams, and it's third down. You look at this defense for Tampa Bay. And this unit, very tough to throw against, currently second best in the NFL.
And I'm struggling a little bit trying to really categorize this crew. They're top 10 in the league against the pass, but the bottom half of the league in sacking the quarterback. That doesn't make sense. Imagine if this group ever put pressure on the QB. And easily move into the top five.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Going underneath, Gibbs has it. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
Ready. Cowboy 80. 19 Lions.
Willis to throw once more. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report from these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Draft 50.
A third and two. Here's Willis. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Now give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there's not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Lions turned away on fourth down, and the Buccaneers defense holds, and they get the football back. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And they, of course, coming into this one in the midst of a tough losing streak. They did get helped out by the open week last week. And in talking with them, all indications were, Charles, that that was a very helpful break.
Yeah, I know a lot of teams, coaches, they hate taking time off in the midst of a losing streak because they think they have to stay on their toes and punch their way out of it. But occasionally, you get that open week, you step back, evaluate what's been going wrong, see what you can put in that can move you forward, and maybe you get a chance to breathe a little bit and kind of start over.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. A gain there of 21 yards. The ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 30-yard line. In motion, Slayton. He'll get an opportunity with it on the touch pass. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Gun with White, and a pretty good run as he'll get this down close to a first at the Lions 21. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. He's got his target. That's complete, and he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. They'll try the right side here with White. And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. Here's Mayfield. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. Now the extra point try forthcoming. And it's good to make it 14-0. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath, first do no harm. And right now they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. They go play action. Mayfield. And there's a short one taken in by Otten. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. First catch for him. It's good for a dozen and a first down.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
A first down run, good for about three. Second and seven coming up. Now Mayfield. Here's White. They set up the screen. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
And that was a beautifully executed screen pass. They let the rushers get upfield and get the escorts in front, meaning the offensive linemen, other blockers out in front, completed the pass beautifully. So now you've got all that open space with big guys leading the way.
On first down, a running play ends up going backwards as he won't get close to the line of scrimmage. In fact, he's going to lose 4 yards. They'll have to deal with a second and 14 now after the loss. Mayfield on play action. To the sideline and incomplete.
They're putting together a drive here in the final minutes of the half, but the coverage has been tight all game long, and they certainly want to keep them off the scoreboard here.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Mayfield to throw it. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14-0. This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Here's White. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Rashad White, his first touchdown on the year. And the Bucs have got it back to within a score. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And that'll make our score 14-7. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll get to the 30-yard line before going out of bounds. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And last time they were stopped on fourth down, had a drive stalled out. We'll see how they respond this go around.
I'm eager to see what their mindset is, because moving the ball, feeling good, and then that abrupt stop on fourth down, Do they go back to the bench and go, oh, boy, they've got something for us? Or do they go to the bench and say, we blew it ourselves. Let's get back out there and move the ball.
Oh, he tried to fit it in on the slant, and it's intercepted. Carlton Davis picks it, and the return will stop right around the 25. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, ah, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
First down, here's White, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Mayfield looks to throw. And he's got his big tight end over the middle, complete. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. White. Is into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. McLaughlin now to add the PAT. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They start from scratch here, so to speak. 14 all following the interception last time that led to a score. Now they've got it first and 10. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. On first down, Willis. Looking left side for Watkins, and he's got it. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35.
Ready, break.
Here's second and 10. Now Willis. Eluding the pressure right. Oh, the turnover fest continues. Here's another interception. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for Buccaneer TD. McLaughlin for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. Fair catch, going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35.
Here we go, here we
so
go.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10.
Dixie Maverick.
To throw, here's Willis. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. To the air on first down, here's Willis. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And this is incomplete. Oh, he had 6 points right in his hands but could not hang on. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the right hash, this from 48. And his kick is indeed good, and that will do it for this first half. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down, two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter three? And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And despite the turnovers, Charles, and they had multiple in that first half, they still have the lead as they begin this third quarter.
And they probably hurt some.
They've got his man complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. It's nearly a 40-yard gain on the opening play of the quarter. So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 37-yard line. And maybe a little over pursuit there as he's able to take this down to the 25-yard line. 70 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. They go right back to White here on first down. And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Mayfield. Left side here, that's complete to Godwin. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 12-yard line. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. The slot man in motion right. Mayfield knocks this forward. It's a jet sweep. And he will score. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Trey Palmer, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Bucs take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And that pushes the lead up to 11. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20. Bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They make their second half debut here, and things are looking a little bit tougher now. You give up the points there, Charles, that touchdown drive on the other side. So now it's a two-score game here. Got to be careful.
They certainly do, and I'm just wondering at halftime if those guys just looked into each other's eyes and realized what they've got to get done and come out a little bit more charged up, because if they don't get some kind of points here, that next drive, that could make this a three-possession game.
Second down and eight. There's gone. Trying to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. Certainly not his best throw that time, and not a good time to make it, Charles, when they were a nickel with five defensive backs on the field.
And that's exactly why you have those five DBs out there. You want extra speed on the field.
guys who have ball skills and understand what the passing game can do and gives them a chance to react and make a play on the football, and they take one of those away.
And he'll get it down this time to the 17. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Now, that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've kind of hit the jackpot.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. Flying in for that sack, Aiden Hutchinson.
Well, they had the right down and the definite distance to take a shot downfield, but it didn't work out the way that they had envisioned.
No, that's a situation where if you take a sack close to the line of scrimmage, it's not that bad, but a loss like that, you can't take a sack there.
Yeah, absolutely. The one thing you cannot do, they did.
And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Going right side is White. And he'll work his way closer to the goal line as he's got five down to the three. So the ball position now at the three. Here's second and goal. White will score. Touchdown, Buccaneers.
Well, this offensive line has really stepped up to the challenge here because those Mastodons, they've been sensational clearing holes all game long. And this is great work down here near the goal line to give their back the space he needs to work his way into the end zone.
McLaughlin now to add the PAT. Oh, I was just about to say he had missed an extra point all season, but there it is, his first miss, no good. So with a missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And he'll elect not to run with it. The fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line.
Here we go.
The Detroit offense ready to begin
value
their drive.
Three.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Here's Goff now on second down. Flushed out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. Oh, the turnover fest continues. Here's another interception. And the Bucs are in great shape here as they take over at their 46-yard line. They exited the pocket trying to improvise. That was a tough throw, and unfortunately, it wound up in the wrong pair of hands.
And, Brandon, when you're on the run, sometimes your downfield vision can get...
Rush coming, and he's taken down. The safety blitz turns out to be a great call defensively as they sack him for a loss of 9. After the sack, it's 2nd and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Mayfield now. This is White on the screen. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up 3rd. They will run with White out of the shotgun. And he gets this to the 48, but no further. Well short of the line to gain. It's a gain of 11, but they're still well short. It's 4th down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. Here comes the Buccaneers punter now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the 4th quarter. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
This pass down the field for Gibbs. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
And they're at the point of the ball game now where they've got to take some chances. They've got to put the ball in the air and just see what happens. But this defense knows that all too well.
That one let go deep for Laporta. This is caught inside the 15. A big play there for Detroit. 42 yards. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. The quick slant caught. Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. To throw on second down is gone. And this one too low.
See, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe he didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
In the fourth quarter, maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there, the legs still there? This has been a tough game. Goff wants to throw on third and one. He had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. They blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Finds Gibbs on the check down. Touchdown! Jahmyr Gibbs from a yard out. And the Lions have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. The extra point up and good. And the lead is trimmed down to 10. So the lead back down to 10 as things get a little more interesting and the kick is away. And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Throwing, Mayfield. He'll get that out to the flat to White. And he'll be upended here after a pickup of 3, getting it out to the 25. The offense on third down, they've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is third and 10. And Mayfield again with the interception, his third. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. I think it's safe to say this is a game he's not going to forget anytime soon, Charles. 3 interceptions.
It's rare that we see 3 interceptions by one team, let alone by an individual. And I think that after the second one, he's probably telling his teammates, any ball that's in the air, it's going to be mine. And that turned out to be true.
And from the 34, here's second and 4. Goff now looking to throw. Looking for Wright, and he finds him. And in for the Lions' touchdown. Brock Wright, 34 yards. And the Lions have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Extra point splits the uprights. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. So just a 3-point game now as they send this one away. From a yard or 2 deep, here comes a return. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And with that last touchdown, I mean, we're set up for a good finish here. Some things to consider, Charles. Obviously, it's a very close game. You're in the fourth quarter. Defensively, they've got all three timeouts in their back pocket.
So the chess match really ramps up, doesn't it? Because in these situations, what do? Do you run the ball and kill the clock here? Or do you try and bury them with another score? And how about defensively? Do you use your timeouts as early as opportunity? Or wait till you hit the two-minute warning? So there's a lot going into this one. Let's see how each side goes about their strategy.
The Lions will use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Here we go, third and one. Gut check time on both sides. They'll try to pick this up on the ground with White. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. And this defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the two-minute warning. And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. To throw, Mayfield. He'll leave this one for White. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. And now here comes the third of their timeouts defensively. So they'll be left with only the two-minute warning to stop it from here on out. From the 29, here's second down at 7. They run straight ahead here with White. Muscles him off. And this is going to be a Bucs first down as the tackle made just shy of the 40.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
5 points of contact necessary at this stage as he'll run on first down. That time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture, right? Every back that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage, but you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them.
Another running situation on the doorstep as they come up second and 10. They give to White on the option. And he's across the 43, extra yards to the 43. And now the question everyone's wondering, look at the clock, late fourth quarter, do they put the ball in the air here on third?
I don't. I run the football and I tell my offensive line, no leakage up front. I don't want my running back hit as I hand the ball off to him. I don't want any type of an issue. But if I am going to throw it, quick throw, out to the perimeter, maybe one of my best receivers running a quick slant or something like that.
So it's third and 6, and this will be the 8th play of the drive. Mayfield to throw. Able to find the open man. That's complete. Down the sideline he goes. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it. And that touchdown, Charles, with very little time remaining, boy, it just sucked any energy and momentum out of the other sideline.
Yeah, take an incredible comeback in the final minute to bring this one back to even. A great series there offensively. They saw an opportunity to slam the window shut, and they followed through.
But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. This is first and 10. And now the Bucs deciding to take a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Goff now to throw. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
You get into these two-minute drill situations and you often got tired legs on the offensive line. But these defenders, they've been rotating in and out, and they're a little bit fresher and quicker. And the pressure there forced the incompletion.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
If this offense can't get it done, they'll think back to just a few plays and say to themselves, this was a winnable game, and we let it get away. Still a chance to save it, but time's definitely running out.
He'll buy some time right. Connects with Peoples Jones, and that's going to be a first down as he's out of bounds to stop the clock. 15 seconds to play. Now Goff. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now.
And let's face it, this defense has had its share of struggles all game long, and they know that they can put it all behind them if they defend well here in the two-minute drill. Excellent coverage right there to force the incompletion.
He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. And the Buccaneers are going to take over at their own two-yard line. Well, it wasn't always pretty, but the interception there, that means that they should get out of here with a victory.
Yeah, this is not a game that they're going to preserve for posterity on defense, but they did finish it off, didn't they? They did make the winning play to close things out. They'll take that one and head to the locker room.
And he'll go out of bounds after getting this across the 15. Charles, a lot of happy faces heading into the tunnel as this one ends. And understandably so, not only did they get the win, but boy, their offense was on fire in this ball game.
And partner, I have no idea what the top speed is on all those high-end sports cars, what's the top gear you can get into. This offense, they certainly...